Everybody, I'm Crandall.
I'm Mercy.
We are Armchair Directors.
Hail Hydra?
Hail Hydra.
That feels wrong, dude.
It does feel wrong.
Just to make that clear. Okay, newest review is Captain America 2, I can't help it, Electric Boogaloo, The Winter Soldier. So, Matt, are we doing spoilers here or not?
We could do maybe very minor spoilers.
Okay, so you've been warned. We're not going to give away. There's not really any... Well, I guess there is kind of a huge spoiler in this movie. And I want to talk about it, so we'll give you a clear spoiler warning when we're about to talk about it at the very end of the review.
Yeah, I think that's the safest. We'll go no spoilers to a point, and then we'll let you know, turn it off if you don't want to have it ruined.
Right. Okay, so Cap 2, the strongest of the Phase 2 offerings we were talking about when we went to see this thing on opening night.
Absolutely, yeah.
So you would put this above Thor 2?
I would. So Thor 2 is a fun movie, and I really liked it, but I think this one... The action is off the charts in Captain America the Winter Soldier in a way that no other Marvel movie has had action this intense, I don't think.
Yeah, and what I really loved about it, especially the first half of the movie, it feels like the, I don't know, the last quarter of the movie just becomes a typical, we've got to get all of the big action set pieces out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
But most of this movie felt like Metal Gear to me. Or I guess Mission Impossible, but... I think Metal Gear has a distinct tone and vibe to it, different than Mission Impossible. Metal Gear, the tagline for it is tactical espionage action. And that's in this movie in spades, especially in the opening scene where Cap infiltrates a boat that's been taken over. It's right out of Metal Gear Solid 2 for people who have played that video game series. He sneaks through, he dispatches of the people one at a time in pretty funny fashion for a few of them.
In spectacular fashion. I think that was the moment where this movie said, hey, guess what? This is Captain America we're dealing with, not just any old spy who's infiltrating a boat. This is a super soldier, and he sure showed those guys on that boat in a way that, like, it was awesome to see him just kick people's asses.
And I also really appreciate the fact that they gave him a suit with dark and muted colors. So it's not just Captain America in the bright red, white, and blue running around like he would in a comic book or in the old days. He's wearing a pretty dark suit, and even the shield was darkened. So this movie does have that level of attention to detail, which I appreciated. And I like the inclusion of Black Widow and Nick Fury. It made it feel like Avengers Light. If you've seen our Avengers review, you know how I just went insane for Avengers. I think it's one of the most fun movies I've ever seen. And Avengers Light isn't, it's not putting it down. It's giving it a ginormous compliment.
Yeah, this movie is an ensemble piece. So Captain America is the star, but they surround him with enough people that really get a lot to do. Nick Fury, and like you said, Black Widow. The Falcon is awesome. Anthony Mackie was great in this movie, I thought. And we get some other agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. like Maria Hill and a couple of bad guys. So it really fills out quite a big cast of characters. And nobody really gets shortchanged other than Emily Van Camp as Agent 13, who has like 8 minutes and doesn't really do much. But everybody gets a really great moment. They've got Robert Redford, so they've added some gravitas to the acting. Yeah. But I think the thing that I really thought was the strong suit of this movie is they got Anthony and Joe Russo, who are known for television comedies, and they gave them this movie, and they directed the shit out of those action scenes.
Mm-hmm.
So all the action scenes, really good camera work, clear, concise geography of what is happening to who. This movie has more bullets than any Marvel movie ever being fired. It's like a bullet fest, and just some really tense action scenes. And it is a political thriller, basically. There's like conspiracies and you don't know who to trust. But I really liked that the whole time we did feel sort of tense and you're paranoid and you don't know where it's exactly going, even when you know sort of exactly where it's going. So I like that it still felt fresh, even though we've seen a few of these plot devices before.
Yeah, and to go back to the Metal Gear Solid comparison, I'm not just talking about sneaking around aspect. I'm talking about how Metal Gear, as the games went on, went into this whole concept of the jugglers and how your government is actually being controlled by this other entity. And this movie has that as well. Won't spoil it yet, but you know, a very prominent power in the States is being influenced. And I thought the inclusion of the Falcon, like, I'm not very familiar with the Captain America comics, so he's flying around and he's cool and stuff, but in my personal opinion, I really wasn't that blown away by Falcon because he just felt like, well, we can't get Iron Man, so who can we put in there that flies? It would have been so, like, obviously it would have been so much better with Tony Stark in there instead of Falcon, but
Maybe, but I like that Cap had another soldier who had been through sim not the same thing that Cap has been through, but it's another guy who can relate to, Cap's situation of being a soldier, not really feeling at home once you're at home. So I thought that that was nice that they had another guy who was sort of displaced to sort of be his right-hand man and back him up.
And I agree. I agree with that. Like the stuff when he's not wearing the wings, but as soon as he puts on the wings, I thought it took some of Cap's specialness away because Cap is the super soldier who runs and jumps and punches really hard. But then you got this other guy who can fly, and he just kind of makes Cap look like a relic and not that interesting.
Yeah, but then he gets owned.
Well, yeah, like when he, yeah, true.
And Cap does it. So it's like minor spoiler alert there. I don't know.
Yeah,
But the Falcon.
he is pretty useless without, just like Stark is pretty useless. Well, Stark
Yeah,
is still
you take the
brilliant.
Falcon's falconness away, and he's just a guy who, gets into a fist fight and happens to outrun a dust cloud.
And we gotta mention who the movie is named after, the Winter Soldier. Good old, I mean, is this a spoiler? We've had some people post messages saying, "Don't spoil it," but my opinion is, you motherfuckers. I
Okay,
mean, this is
here come the spoilers. This shouldn't be a spoiler. I thought everybody knew this. Go
this is
ahead.
old. Like, how old is this secret? Decades?
Yeah.
How far are we going to push this? Don't say that Bruce Wayne is Batman.
Right.
The Winter Soldier is Bucky Barnes, Cap's old childhood friend who falls off the train in the first movie, and it was a very, yeah, kind of, it left me wanting more death. I thought, well, what's going on there? That's kind of lame. And the reason for that is he didn't die. They were setting up the Winter Soldier. I just watched Cap 1 before I went into Cap 2. Glad I did because it reminded me that before Cap saves Bucky Barnes, they were experimenting on him. So
Yeah.
there was just that little morsel that I needed
They set it up.
that they didn't just grab some guy out of thin air and say, hey, this guy's the villain. They actually gave a little bit of foreshadowing, which is enough for me. I thought the guy did a fantastic job. Great look, great action scenes. You were talking about the fight scenes. I think the fight scenes in this movie have a real science to them. It was like watching a good MMA fight. I shouldn't just say MMA fight because some of them
Right.
are horrible, but there was some really beautiful choreography, and a lot of them end in an MMA fashion, like in a chokeout. So I thought the Winter Soldier was fantastic, and I absolutely love the shield versus the arm segments of the fights, and bringing up the shield. I love Cap's shield. I love the fact that it isn't some goofy, stupid weapon that they've saddled him with and they're stuck with because that's what he's always had. They've actually taken the shield and they've run with it, and kind of in a way, Cap is not special at all to me when he doesn't have the shield. It's like that's actually the best part of him. It's like Thor and Mjolnir.
But I like how, he uses the shield for whatever the situation calls. He uses it as a shield. He throws it around as a projectile. He jumps out of a window and uses it as padding. So it's got multi-use. You mentioned, the worst kept secret that Bucky Barnes is the Winter Soldier. The dudes behind us when we saw this movie, when he was being unmasked, the one friend went, "It's going to be GSP."
Oh
And I
God.
was like, oh my God, because George St. Pierre is in this movie earlier as Batroc, and they thought that the Winter Soldier was going to be the guy from the beginning. And I thought, what idiots, because this guy doesn't even look, it's Bucky Barnes right away. Even if you forget what that guy looks like, they remind you in the movie by showing pictures of him at all these different places so that it's not a huge jaw-dropping shock. But the guys behind us were so dumb that they didn't even see it coming.
Yeah, every theater has those guys in it. All right, time for best part.
Worst part.
I'm going to kick off best part with Nick Fury finally getting to really kick some ass because he's just been a mouthpiece this entire time in all the Marvel movies. The closest he's ever come, I think, to kicking any ass was shooting a rocket launcher at one of his own planes in the Avengers, which was a cool image. Like, we've got that picture of Nick Fury with a rocket launcher, but he didn't really do anything with it. He's shooting one of his own planes. When he comes under fire in this
Oh,
movie,
yeah.
holy shit, that was the scene where I was on the edge of my seat and I was like, you know, I was a kid again, just kind of almost bouncing up and down, going, fucking A, fucking yes.
As soon as he gets on that gun, after the window reaches 0% effectiveness, just badass.
Yeah, like the countdown, the tension, is he going to make it? Are they going to get him? And I just love that they didn't turn Nick Fury into a bitch.
Right.
I just picture Sam going, nah, 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 I'm not going to be a bitch. And it just seems like there were several moments where he was almost made a bitch, and he just gets out of that scene not looking like a bitch.
Yeah.
So I absolutely love that scene. Worst part for this movie is the worst part for most Marvel movies for me. It's where we need to just blow everything up at the end. And then you've got your, you know, dun, 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 this guy's actually behind everything and he's the villain. Won't spoil who it is, but... I was like, instead of being blown away and impressed, I was more like, ah, shit. You know, another turncoat Benedict Arnold. It's so formulaic. So,
and it was so obvious. Like, it was one of those things where, like, of course that had to be the bad guy.
Yeah. Yeah. So that was my worst part.
I'm going to go worst part. This is a long movie. There are a few scenes. I wouldn't excise any of these scenes. The Russos are so strong at comedy on TV. There's a lot of scenes that end with like a sarcastic or like a witty line, but I think only half of them actually land. So there's a few times where the comedy feels like awkward and forced into these weird scene endings that I don't dig. And not any time more noticeable than Black Widow gets a big fight scene towards the end with the main villain.
Oh, yeah.
And she like has a couple one-liners after she gets like electrocuted, and that stuff didn't work. And at first, when the old councilwoman starts kicking ass, I thought that was way cooler than having it be Black Widow in a magic mask. So I know they wanted to work Black Widow into the finale, but I wish they had found a better way to do it, because it just felt like they needed to get Scarlet more screen time. And they keep giving her these weird lines that don't quite work half the time.
And did you feel that Scarlett was just kind of phoning it in? She seemed cow-eyed in this movie, not really that interested. Even her hairstyle, which is supposed to be a big thing for girls in these types of movies, right? Oh, what amazing hair.
Yeah,
and it was just boring. And also, she didn't look like she was in the best of shape either.
Well, and like they give her a lot more to do, and she has some really good scenes, but only half of them really feel like really good scenes. And yeah, you're right. It feels like she's kind of phoning it in the rest of the time, or they just didn't know what to do, so they threw Black Widow in there.
She didn't even get to really tease a romantic relationship with Cap. She's wearing an arrow pendant necklace the entire movie, which is kind of, they're reminding you she's with a guy who's not in this movie. Hawkeye.
Right, Hawkeye.
So she couldn't even do like the... All she has with Cap is like a friendship, a brotherly love.
Yeah, and I think that actually speaks volumes, Black Widow in this movie, against having Black Widow have her own movie. Like, she works fine as sort of tagging along with a bigger gang, but I don't think that character is interesting enough to be the lead of her own movie. Right. Best part, I think that the directors really nailed this tone, you know, for the most part, the action, the intensity, and it just feels like a 70s political thriller with huge action. And it makes Captain America less boring than Captain America usually is, because he is still a Boy Scout. He's still always doing the right thing. But because of the storyline, half the time you don't know what the right thing actually is.
Right.
And I thought that was really interesting. So the directors really handled that well. And just the way that all that action was choreographed and filmed so that it didn't feel as if it was choreographed was fantastic.
Yeah. And I'm just going to throw in my two cents. I love Captain America. Didn't at first. Thought Evans was the wrong choice for him. But I remember thinking, I hope he grows into the role.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this is the movie where he finally grew into the role, because he wasn't quite nailing it yet in Avengers for me. But in this movie, he's got that kind of that steeliness to him, that self-assuredness. You know, I'm a good guy, and I'm cool with that. You know,
it's because now Captain America himself has seen Star Wars, so he knows how a real hero should act.
Yeah, exactly. But I really dig the old Boy Scout basically like a Christopher Reeve Superman is exactly how Evans is playing it in this movie.
Mm-hmm.
And I like how you mentioned that they take this old Boy Scout and they put him in this day and age where everyone hates. I mean, they just fucking hate everything. People hate our show. I mean, they will hate anything.
They'll hate anything.
They'll walk out of this movie and hate. We had people around us going, "This sucked." It's not a bad
movie. Yeah, they were debating if it was the worst Marvel movie ever, and I thought, I just want to shake these people and be like, what are you talking about?
Yeah, so that's why I think they made a really good statement in this movie. It's not the whole point of the movie, but it's a good little statement about, it's just a fucking hating society, and Cap notices it. He's like, you people suck. You really are not nice.
Yeah, what has happened here?
What am I fighting for? And that's kind of what Man of Steel failed to do. What am I fighting for? I'm a good, honest, pure, hardworking guy who stands up for the right thing. What am I fighting for? So I'm glad they addressed that.
And I'm sure one thing I want to mention, 2 weeks from now, Johnny Depp Transcendence opens. And this movie lifts a plot point directly out of that movie. So I'm sure the makers of Transcendence saw Captain America and were just screaming, fuck, at the screen when Zola shows up as this computer cyber intelligence.
Oopsie.
I'm sure they were losing their mind.
And that was another thing I wanted to mention. Man, everybody, it felt like, who was in Captain America 1 shows up in this one, even if it's just a picture on a wall.
Tip of the hat to the first one as much as they could, which is nice.
So it's a sequel to Captain America Part 1, not a sequel to the Avengers. It addresses some things in the Avengers, but just in passing. This is really meant to follow up and build on the first movie.
And they tease Avengers 2 briefly, and of course, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., the TV show, has to address the events of this movie. We'll have to see how they do it.
They might have to do a title change for that show now.
Marvel's Agents of Hydra.
Oops. Spoiler warning. All right. Thanks a lot for listening, and until next time.
Enjoy the show. It's nothing personal.
It kind of feels personal.